In this video, we are adding 9 more huge parts to our scary Leovincible world that's entirely made out of Lego. So if you haven't watched the first part, I will leave a link in the description down below. So be sure to go watch that one if you haven't already. That being said, let's get straight into this video. Alrighty guys, for number 10, we're going to be adding the Sears monster with his big red claws. And we're also adding the Infinite IKEA. I know this isn't like an original, this is actually a SCP-3008 like creation, but adding this one as well. Alrighty guys, number 10 is complete, and here we have the Sears monster looking awesome with his tongue sticking out and his creepy teeth and eyes and big red hands as well. And we also have the IKEA monster as well to go along with it. So let me know what you guys think about this one. And now let's add it to the group and move on to the next one. Alrighty guys, for number 11, we're going to be adding the Woods Are Hungry, and this one kind of reminds me of the Train Eater a little bit. And also, Home Is Where the Heart Is. Alright guys, number 11 is complete, and here we have the two monsters. We also made it so they can connect to this, so we have a ton of like foresty area, tons of trees, plants on the ground, dark green plates, normal green plates, and it looks awesome. But let me know what you guys think. Now let's move on to the next one. Alrighty guys, for number 12, we're going to be adding 3 monsters, and the first one is No Man. And the second one is going to be Behind This Door, and we're just going to be putting them in this creepy little bedroom area. And last but not least, we're going to be adding the Spider in the Dark, and we're going to be putting this guy on the roof. Alrighty guys, number 12 is complete, and here we have the 3 monsters, one down here, and then one in the top floor, and then one on the roof. And if you're wondering what the front of the house looks like, this is what it looks like. It's just pretty plain. But anyway, there it is, the 2-story house with the 3 monsters, and it looks awesome. Let me know what you guys think, though, and let's add this to the group. Alrighty guys, for number 13, we are adding the Double Mammoth. Alrighty guys, number 13 is complete, and here we have the Double Mammoth, and I am super happy on the way this one turned out. It is extremely fragile, I do want to mention that, because it's just like filled with ton of like tiny like technical pieces and stuff. Let me know in the comment section down below what you guys think. So that does it for number 13. Now let's move on to the next one. Alrighty guys, for number 14, we're going to be adding the Lurking Wardrobe. And we're also going to be adding this little guy, and this one is Creeps in the Night. Alrighty guys, number 14 is complete, and here we have this little guy just chilling up here, and then we have this humongous brown building, also using these really huge glass windows, so you can just see the terrifying creature in there just chilling as well. So that does it for number 14. Stay tuned, because you're not going to want to miss out on the rest of it. Alrighty guys, for number 15, we're adding one of the creepiest creatures in my personal opinion, and that is never walk alone in a dark place. This one is absolutely terrifying. It's got a lot of these little tentacle-like pieces, and you basically just use a little pin to connect them into the monster, and then you also have these arms using swivel pieces so the arms can move. But yes, that does it for this monster. Now let's add it to the piece. Alrighty guys, number 15 is complete, and here we have the creepy monster in this like alleyway type setting. I think it looks absolutely terrifying, and we use a lot of these miscellaneous random like barrels and stuff just to add to like the nostalgic look of a creepy old setting almost. But yes, that does it for number 15. Now let's move on to the next one. Alrighty guys, for number 16, we're near the water, so for that reason, we gotta add the lighthouse, also known as the walking lighthouse. Alrighty guys, number 16 is complete, and here we have the lighthouse just chilling on the beach here. We used a lot of these trans light blue pieces, which just look really awesome in my opinion. I think it was just a perfect fit for this. And then we also used these like tentacle-like pieces surrounding the lighthouse as well, and I just added a really nice touch to it. So that does it for number 16. Now let's move on to the next one. Alrighty guys, for number 17, we're gonna be adding the bird wasn't fast enough. This is a creepy looking worm thing. I don't know, I think it's pretty terrifying. And we're also adding the empty figure. Alrighty guys, number 17 is complete, and here we have the two monsters, and we also added this little splatter of like lava on the road. I don't know, I just thought it was kind of cool. A couple trees, some fencing to go along with that, abandoned railroad, and that'll do it for number 17, and let's add it to the group. Alrighty guys, in order to finish off our last piece, we're gonna be adding fairy gates. This one's pretty terrifying, and I also add this big swivel piece, so in the tunnel you can just move it around, which is pretty creepy. But yeah, let's add it to the piece. And our last creature that we're adding to the entire world, we're gonna be adding Gut the House. This one's pretty terrifying. But yeah, let's add it. And we're gonna be adding this little roof piece to put on here to cover up the train tunnel. Alrighty guys, part number 18 is complete. Our last and final piece is finished. Here we have Gut the House, and we also have the fairy gates just hiding in this little train tunnel, which looks absolutely terrifying. But yes, extremely happy with this one. Now let's add it to the group. Alrighty guys, it is complete. Here we have Leo Vincible's creepy world completely made out of Lego using his most popular characters featured on his Instagram page. I will leave a link in the description down below so you can go check out all of his creepy creatures on there. But yes, here it is. Lots of pieces. I would say probably 20,000 Lego pieces in this whole creation using 18 gray base plates. Yeah, that's a lot. So enough chit chat. Let's take a quick little look of this amazing creepy world of Leo Vincible creations.